they'll tell me I am online soon because I've made up this song. Hello and welcome to the stream. Today's pre-stream chatter. I'm really running out of stuff, so I basically just made up a song called Streaming by a River, which probably someone has already written and sing. I shouldn't have said singing. I was saying the words of the song in what I thought was a melodic tone, but clearly that is, I do not know how to sing. Okay, it has been a little while since I've streamed last time, and you're welcome for the break. I'm not sure if I'll get back to streaming regularly again, if there is such a thing for me. And in fact, there's a lot of stuff we're in the middle of, and so you might think, well, you probably don't think at this point, that we'd get back to some of it and try to like wrap it up and actually get a published product, you know, an answer or even a blog post or even a web page on GitHub Pages, something that we could say, hey, we've done something, but no. The goal here is to always get right in the middle of projects and then stop. So I think what we're going to do today is start a different project, of course. By the way, I did figure out, I did a little bit of coding off stream, not a great deal. I did figure out that one really good way to get a lot of data in, which I actually knew before but had forgotten, is to upload it to a file using cut and paste, because they won't allow upload if you don't pay them. And then just you do this double arrow notation to pull the data in. So we could, this was for the magnitude of a planet problem. The goal was going to be to show that if you look at the magnitudes of all the planets compared to the phase curve, you know, the phase that they are, and you've accounted for distance and from the sun and from where you are and for the albedo and whatever else we were accounting from, they actually turn out to be about the same, which sort of makes sense because, you know, the main way planets differ, kind of, is how much they reflect and how far they are from us and how far they are from the light source, which is, in our case, is the sun. So that was sort of a surprising, that was going to be a surprising, the take on all of this. I remember doing it vaguely once, but I don't remember what results I came up with. But that would give us an actually pretty good approximation to a magnitude of the planet without having to go into a lot. It's actually more complicated because planets do have different phase behavior. In fact, our moon not only has different phase behavior, but because of libration, which is like the tippling of the moon, and the fact that different parts of the moon reflect light differently, sometimes considerably. The Tycho crater reflects a lot of light. Other parts of the moon reflect less light. So even if the moon is in the same phase two times, the part of the moon you see may not be the same, and the brightness of the moon may not be the same. So it's more complicated than just looking at phase, albedo, and, you know, distance from light source and distance from viewer. But that was our simplification. But I don't know why I said all that, because we're not doing that. Instead, someone came up with a interesting-ish question on astronomy that, ooh, someone's answered me somehow. okay, so this is a question I put a comment on. What star is closest to Betelgeuse? And of course, the correct answer here, as given by the whimsical but brilliant uh-oh, is Michael Keaton, because he, of course, played that role in a movie. By the way, if I do say that name more than three times in this stream, there is a chance that he, by which I mean Michael Keaton, will show up. However, it is not that likely. So the question, what I suggested was using the Gaia 2 star directory, which is huge. It's got like over a billion stars in it, maybe 2 billion, and seeing what star is closest to Betelgeuse. Several problems with this. I've said it twice now. Several problems with this. One is this guy doesn't know how to use at notifications, but that's not really a problem. Betelgeuse would not be in Gaia itself, but that's okay because, as Steve Linton points out, all you need is the coordinates of Betelgeuse, the X, Y, and Z coordinates compared to the galactic equator, and then you could find, you know, what stars are sort of close to it. So I'm excited. Now, there is a problem with using the Gaia DR2 catalog, or even the Hipparchos catalog, which somebody else suggested. Actually, the Hipparchos might be okay. Even though Gaia has a lot of data for star positions, for star that you could theoretically use to compute star position, the biggest error there is going to be in the parallax data. The parallax data tells us how far a star is from us. It uses the Earth's orbit to determine the distance to a star, because as the Earth orbits the Sun, the position of the star changes slightly in the background. Unfortunately, many of the Gaia DR2 parallax values are terribly off. They're very open about this. They have a parallax error field that tells you, and some of them are even negative, which is theoretically impossible. I mean, it is possible if you have proper motion and stuff, but they correct for that. So that just means the readings are really, really bad. Now, it turns out, and there's more, a really brilliant scientist whose name I'm going to need to remember because he's really cool and he actually answered my email, which makes you cooler than cool, found a way to correct for this, for the parallaxes, by making some statistical assumptions. Unfortunately, I mean, and so we could use that data instead. Unfortunately, those corrections, he openly admits this, make assumptions that are true for most stars, but not for all stars in the Gaia DR2 catalog. So even though we have a position for all the Gaia DR2 catalog stars in this these files, professor, who I need to remember his name, gave me access to, very nice of him. They're supposed to be available on, I think, Vizier or something, but they're not. We really can't know that whatever the quote-unquote answer is the correct answer. So lots of problems with this. We're going to approach this in 17 billion different ways because that's confusing. Okay, we are going to create its own file for this called README Closest. And we will mention the problem name here because I'm really bad about not doing that. Define star closest to you know what? He who shall not be named. Okay, so we have several catalogs here. The HYG data catalog is actually pretty good, and that's that one we can use to get sort of the, you know, we could say, well, in the HYG data catalog, it's this star, and you know, we could even say this is the visible star that's closest to Betelgeuse, blah blah blah. Now, there's several ways to do this, and we will do it in the hardest possible way because it is so freaking cool. I don't know why I'm saying this. I'm not even reading, looking over this. So really, we could just find the XYZ position of Betelgeuse and then find the XYZ position of everything else and compare the distance using the Pythagorean theorem. That would be the easiest way to do it. Now, the reason I'm not going to do that, I mean, I could do that, is we also kind of want to give a little bit more information. We want to be able to say, well, this is the closest star to Betelgeuse in the HYG data catalog. We will go to the other one soon, and the unedited and edited Gaia DR2 catalogs. But also we might want to say, you know, here's the second closest one, and here's the closest one that could be visible to the naked eye, blah, 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 blah. In fact, we might want to say, you know, here are the five closest stars to Betelgeuse according to HYG data version 3. So how do we do that? Well, just guess that we're going to use Wolfram Cloud. And I think, should I save this? Yeah, let me create a new notebook here. Let me actually be a little bit better about this. We will name it closest star because we can actually use this to do a little bit more than just find the closest star to he who shall remain unnamed. So how are we going to do this? I think there is a Wolfram function called closest, which I probably could have gotten easier. No, there is not. Nearest, it might be nearest. And if it's not, I'm going to have to actually look for it. Okay, here we go. Nearest. Nearest neighbor graph is actually quite interesting because it'll show you if you wanted to go star hopping in real life, and we're limiting yourself to the HYG data catalog stars, what the shortest hops would be between the stars. We are not doing that, so we don't really need this, but let's take a look at nearest. Gives the property prop for the, oh, come on. We're looking for like the n, there we go, gives the nearest n elements. I believe by default they use Pythagorean distance. Now it'd be tempting to build sort of a cross table of all the stars' distances, like they have those trip distances, or did in olden days, matrices, but this there's too many stars in HYG data to really do that. Could we create an app in JavaScript to do that? I said it, and it is Pomodoro time, but since this is the first one, we're going to skip it. We will not be skipping the other ones. I will not be skipping the other ones. Oh boy, I actually didn't want to say that. Now that I just said it and it kind of slipped out, it would make an interesting JavaScript program. You type in the name of your star. Again, not all the stars have names. And it'll tell you when the star is, the closest stars to that star. Damn. Crap. I kind of want to do that now. Now, first of all, let's see if, this is going to probably ruin everything for us. Beetlejuice, ooh, third time, Michael Keaton might show up, has garnered some interest because it is behaving oddly, and some people believe it may go nova, or since it's, 700 light years away, may already have gone nova, but the light won't reach us, and, but we won't see it until, obviously, the light travels that distance. It's actually getting dimmer, so that's not necessarily, ooh, okay, hang on. This might be, am I into new territory here? I mean, it's not difficult new territory. Betelgeuse is not that close to the sun. Oh, hang on. Oh, that's nice. You have a category called Betelgeuse? I've done it enough times now that it doesn't matter anymore. Alright, let's look here. Okay, maybe this is new uncharted territory, as we say. I don't know who says that. Okay, so now, suddenly we've changed gears. This is awesome, we're in the middle of like 20 different unfinished projects, and I've now taken the one project we might have had a chance to finish and turned it into something that we're gonna have great difficulty finishing. So let's go into, I do have this on REPL, I do have the star list on REPL, and a few other things there that would be very useful. I love the way they start me on a page that's totally useless to me. All right, and I think this is going to be... No scroll bar, please. I hate it when people give me scroll bars. I mean, yuck. All right. Twitch. One of these, the star map may have the entire HYG data. Oh, fucking hell. No, I don't need to do that. Seriously? This piece of shit, someone's really sue these guys. They're becoming kind of assholes. This is interfering with my ability to get to my stuff. Of course, it's not that serious here, but if someone fucked it up with a, if they did a bank or something and you couldn't get to your data, I could see where people get pissed off. So let's kill them. Okay, bclib, bclib.js, listener, script. So somewhere in here, I don't think script will have it, though. I might not have it anywhere at all, actually. Well, that's not true. I do have it somewhere, but I might not have it anywhere in something that's called Twitch something. So this is a Twitch streamer. And I'm sure it's not in bclib. It better not be in one of those, because that's not a good place for it. All right, so it's not going to be there. Now we get to the difficult part of finding where the hell something is on that isn't really obvious. Data server, which is cool, but it turns out I'm never going to use that. Heliacal You know, for some reason I get the feeling that I might have done something here that lets you actually list a star, but this might also be might be limited to the number of stars it lists. Motherfucker. Okay. And this is, I think, actually on GitHub Pages somewhere. I don't know where. Actually, maybe I do know where. But let's see. Bright star. So I think this is not going to be all of the HYG stars. So let's see if it is. Yeah, this is only the named star. So there's going to be like more than 132 of them. The fuck? Wow, that is not a lot of stars. Okay, so screw that. So we will now continue trying to find. This is good. We're now like four or five levels deep in. I do know I have this because I've actually looked at this before. Old star map. Well, that could be it. And at some point, of course, we can just recreate the file we need. We don't have to get it from somewhere. I just want to see if I've ever done something like this before. And why is this in Java? Not cool. Oh, this is a really old star map. This is one that I did ages ago. All right, map server testing, Terra map tools. Some of these just have, CSpice did not work here. Ah, here we go, HYG stars in static. I don't know what the hell that means anymore. Oh, actually I do. This is, I wanted to see if you could draw the HYG stars fast enough on screen, but I didn't want to actually do the work, so I just decided to look. You probably can't see this because my frame rate is too slow, but this is actually pretty good, looks like pretty good static that we would get back in the 70s and 80s before we had magic television like you do now. So this was my proof that yes, you can actually print, you can actually, can I stop this? Apparently not. That you can actually, I probably need to stop this at some point, but that you can actually get stars updated very, very quickly if you need to, even if they're random. Obviously, when you do the star map, they wouldn't be. All right, stars.js is probably the file I'm looking for. It's huge. It's huge, like Trump's hands. That was a diss to President Trump there. Everyone does that. Oh, hang on. Have we gone uncool here? Okay, and the other problem, by the way, is going to be, of course, there's no way we're going to be able to fit the whole Gaia catalog in there. I mean, that's just ridiculous. So don't expect that to happen. Unfortunately, I get the feeling once again that this is actually a much more limited version of not the whole. This is fun. Yeah, actually, there's one way. I think we can find the size of it if we do something. Nope. Good, we have nothing. All right, screw it. We will, as always. We were going to start a new REPL anyway. Let's make this, pin this, and let's. I'm going to leave this like this because I may want to use it later, but for right now, let's see if we can REPL it this bitch. Okay. I don't know why I did that. New REPL. This sucker. Twitch. Now, notice how very cleverly, which is not at all clever, I'm not naming it after the star, but after, I think this is actually a thing. I think this is actually not juice from a beetle, but I think there's actually a thing called Beetlejuice that is not the star, the monster, or juice from a beetle. But I also don't care. Okay, this is being kind of wonky. So I'm going to create a actually, I think I can upload this file called stars.js. Now I need to create the motherfucker. Come on, I've done this. Neither of those is going to be big enough. That's kind of interesting. Oh, that's, what star would appear brightest in the night skies of other stars? Okay. So, come on. I've done this, but it's probably not in this, well, hell, if this is in there, then the JS version should be in there, shouldn't it? All right, hang on. I can't do that here. All right, give me 1 second to watch. I'll try to find it on my other machine. I should have this, actually. Okay. Yeah, that's not great. That wasn't a great idea. Give me a sec here while I try to find this. And again, We are doing the standard practice of taking more time to find something than it would take to recreate it. Oh. Oh, oh, oh. Ooh. I'm just going to say that a few more times. It apparently, I do have it in here somewhere. But again, I think it's the wrong one. Yeah, it's the one that only has the brighter stars in here, not all of them. I'm convinced that I have done this. And I know I've done it for C, but only again for the brightest stars. Damn it! I swear to God. Well, either I don't have it, or I have it somewhere I can't find it, which is pretty much the equivalent, actually. So what are we going to do with this data? Well, let's see. We don't really need all of crap. So now, once again, I'm going to flip and think that maybe this is too much data for REPL. I'm going to actually try it, though. So what we're going to need here, for minimalism, the very least... You know, and one reason I might not have done this is because getting star names is difficult. That's our sun, by the way. Because some of them have proper names, others of them have, like, Greek bear names. Some others of them just have numbers, like, you know, 17 Phoenix or something. And others of them have, like, no denotation whatsoever, which is a freaking pain in the ass, by the way. Let's see. So we will try it with REPL. We will fail. Actually, maybe not fail. Let's see. And I think we need to do stars of blank, which stars is going to be an array, equal... And I think that's... We just need the x, y, and z coordinates after that. So... I'm going to regret saying that. That's probably not true. Stars of... We will need to add names to them at some point. God damn it, I'm so sure I've done this before. Yep, but no idea where the hell I've done it. The HIP2 data is actually going to be a subset of this. Okay. This is going to drive me nuts. All right. Let's go ahead and, again, it's going to take way less time at this point to... Okay. And maybe I ended up doing it and getting rid of it because it didn't... I mean, I don't do that, though. So let's make sure we have the correct fields, at least. That's field 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 through 19. Which I could do, I'm so clever, like this. Again, this is just for printing purposes, I'm not going to use it like this. Oh, haha. Of course, we have to use our comma as our separator, if we want to do that. ID XYZ, which is exactly what we want, and of course it looks stupid because of the way we're doing it. So... Oh, you know what? Maybe I have... Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. I might have it in here. I might have done it. Ah, there we go. Convert h4jm4OyJT98 to JS useful form. Boo fucking yeah. Okay. Oh, wow, and I think I even tried to figure out what the name... No, I don't think I did. Shit. Really? All right, well, let's see what this does. This looks like it's our best shot at the moment. We will move it to the top, and then we will say, shh, one-liners. And let's see what that spits out for us. Oh, nice. Not that nice. But this is actually pretty good. This is pretty close to what we want. All right, so I'm going to modify this, so I don't want to overwrite it though. So I will go ahead and put a distances only. Oh, actually, I had this, which was before, which was also had other stuff we didn't need. We do not need to, now, this was only magnitude 5 or less, so we don't need to do that. And I don't even think we need to, at this point, say the ID is going to be just to be the canonical location. Because we're not skipping stars at this point. So $F0 equals... This is actually a very bizarre thing, because Perl also interprets brackets itself. Let's see if this works, and if it does, we will, of course, we will get rid of the fields we don't need. Yep. But, of course, it won't work, because I have had an if statement in there that I need to get rid of this quotation mark for. Always something. Okay, the first line's not going to work, but that's probably okay. All right, X, Y, Z... Do we have a name in here? We don't. Somehow I determined the name over here, did I? Did I come up with the name anywhere? Oh, no. I don't think I did. That one I do remember. The name is a serious pain for these things. Alright, so we need... We don't really need the ID anymore. No, because we're going to keep it. We have to minimize this data as much as possible. We don't need any of this, so we can close this here. And this is all heading towards something that's not going to work, by the way. Yeah, we will get rid of the first line. I'm pretty sure JavaScript won't handle that. So. Now, the other issue here is if we wanted to be really stingy, this data is in parsecs, and we probably don't need this much precision. This is a millionth of a parsec, which is not very much. Let me see. Wolfram Alpha will tell it. Parsec divided by a million. Why do I bother? That's... technically correct, and see, this was where I was hoping to get like a Wolfram Alpha thing going. Yeah, screw it. But I mean, that might be getting too trivial. We will be shaving digits off of this, but okay. So now let's make sure the end looks okay by going to 99%. And this does look like a file that is going to break Replit. So we'll call it All Stars, because it also sounds like that song by group that I can't remember. Somebody once told me that group was gonna slip out of my mind. I'm not the brightest star in the... Okay. Babble. Now we're gonna try to upload this. If I remember correctly, it actually, you can upload it, but it becomes like a real pain afterwards. So, that was a little bit too easy. Okay. Let's go ahead and script source that in then. Oh, I think I do need to make one edit to it. That is to get rid of the top line. I'm going to try doing this in Replit. This will break it. Yeah, I should have edited it first and then uploaded, but no, I'm going to break Replit instead. This, I was kind of joking about that, but I think this might actually end up breaking Replit. Damn. Okay. All right. So what's nice is now we know it can read the whole damn thing. So now what we can do here in our script.js is... do this. And magic does not happen. Stars is not defined. Well, you know, it is. And I did include it, but you know, we never know. Yeah, well, actually if stars 17 isn't defined, then stars 0 isn't gonna be. Oh, fudge. That's right. You have to declare stars as an array before you can do all this magic. Ooh, yeah. And now, because we haven't broken enough things, we're going to push this to Git and break it there, too. I'm very excited. All right. Looks like we've done it. When am I going to find out where these Gits are? Because I am freaking excited. All right, it is Pomodoro time, and I am taking this one back in 2 and 2. And we are almost back. And, well, we're still almost back. Okay. Now we probably are back. Okay, so now, so this is working now. The thing we want to do here now is we want to find the distance between two stars. But actually, if we're only going to be looking for the n closest stars, we don't necessarily have to look at the distance. It's easier to compute the distance squared, use that to sort, and then take the square root to get the actual distance. That it's a little bit easier. Okay, now, let's see. And the other issue is going to be something. Okay. And I'm going to do this again incorrectly, but I'll make a to-do, which makes it all legal and happy. Only compute, and I'm going to go ahead and actually sort all of the stars by their distance from a given star, using ksort or whatever that magic sort is in JavaScript. But we don't need to do that. And this routine specific to this proc. I'm not going to write this in my standard way. I'm going to write this as function d2 that takes two objects, star 1 and star 2, we can call them. And there might be a better way of writing this, but I don't know. And yes, I know I'm missing squares. I get to that in a minute. So this is a trivial function, but it doesn't follow my normal pattern of sending in an object. I think that is the JavaScript notation for squaring. And it's a very trivial function, doesn't do a hell of a lot. So we can... I'm going to do a very silly looking test here, which is... I'm going to do two silly tests here. One is a distance to a star from itself, which of course should be zero. Distance squared, I should say. Stars 17, quote, quote. Yep, that's good. And now I'm going to look at the distance of Betelgeuse from our sun, which is actually a known number. I mean, these are all known numbers, but our sun is star 0. Patient 0, corona. Haha, get it, because the sun has it. Never mind. We will now z-grep for this, because I don't know what its number is. That is not acceptable. I know it's in here. Oh, I apparently have case insensitive shit turned off. So this is this, because this is the catalog in this funky catalog. It has different numbers in different catalogs, but we're using the HYG data catalog, and according to this, this is going to be in parsec, so this should be fun. Make that. That was just 3.26 light years. So according to this, motherfucker. All right, let's put this out a little bit here. D2. All right, let's see. We want D2, then the square root, then the end of the console log. Okay. And because this is in parsecs, we need to multiply by 3.26-ish. 497, that's that right? All right, hang on. Let's see. I thought it was more than that, but I mean... come on, where's distance? Yeah, I know they're kind of off. God damn it. None of this actually answers my... Where did my... Oh. I'm off the edge of the screen here, aren't I? Okay, hang on. God damn it. Wait. But that's not necessarily, that's distance in angular distance. But that might be something to look for. Let's, God damn it. Wow. Again. Ooh. So either this number is way, way off. I'm using the wrong ID, maybe, or something else is wrong. Never really know. All right, let's take a look here. Well, I know Sirius is about 8 light years away, so let's find that real quick. We're going to cheat and find a star that we know has a much better behaved... I'm sure I used the zeroth term as my... as the array index, as it were. How far is Sirius? You better tell me 8 light years or I will hurt you. Yeah, there we go. I believe this is correct. This is a very simple function. It would be difficult for it to be wrong. Okay, so now what we want to do is we want to compute the distances from a given star to all other stars, well, including itself, but that's kind of irrelevant, to all other stars, distance squared and then square rooted to get the... So how do we do that? I think JavaScript has this bizarre ksort function that lets you sort an array by... This is going to get ugly, but in a good way. I think it's called ksort. Yep. By a given... That's PHP. I wonder if we do this with JavaScript. That is not what I want. Here we go, PHP's ksort in JavaScript. Maybe it doesn't have it. Whoa, ugly. That can't be correct. Oh, wow. There's something called PHPJS, which normally I would not be interested in, but PHP does have a lot of useful functions, so maybe... Ooh. There's even a ksort here. So now I'm torn between using an existing package, which I should do, and just showing that it can actually... Well, obviously it can be done without... Everything has to be built up from primitives. So it obviously can be done without ksort already existing. And the question is, do I actually want to do that? I'm more excited by having something that will give me all PHP functions, if there is such a thing. Let's take a look at this real quickly. All right, let's take a look at JavaScript. I think maybe JavaScript sorting might be a little bit more sophisticated. And let's go to the source. This I need to really, really, at some point, put down as like one of my top things. Okay, I can sort by... okay. Okay, we can provide a compare function. So, so it's the array.sort.compare function. We could, of course, put the compare function inline, but I'm not going to do that. Okay. Yeah, this is going to kill us. All right. So we're back in business. So we can go back over here to REPL, which I should have done this to. No. I said no. Okay, but anyway. Close the other tabs. Okay. So what we want to do here is we want to the function which we're going to call compare, brilliantly, which takes two arguments. And we're going to return... Now here's where it gets interesting. It's actually not going to be... We're going to choose a fixed star that's going to be global because we have to do distance comparison to it. And the star we're going to choose is Betelgeuse, Betelgeuse, Betelgeuse. Okay. And this is the star, obviously, we'll let our users input at some point. So what we want to return is basically the distance of... Now, this is going to be consistent, but I don't know which order it's going to go into. Actually, I'm not sure that matters. So this is going to return a positive, negative number, probably not zero unless... Well, it could, I guess, but let's pretend that's not going to happen. And so now... We can just do... So this is apparently ksort is built in unless I'm going to... Something horrible is going to happen, but it looks like the way it is, ksort's built in because you can sort by a given any method you want. And so I'm sure that the array represents, it returns an array, doesn't, the problem I'm worried about here is that I don't know if it changes the array or if it doesn't change the array. I guess one way to find out is if it does change the array, which would be bad behavior, by the way, then console log star 17 is going to give us a different result unless it's very, very unlucky and this actually happens to be the star that's, you know, whatever. That did not change, so I think we need to do, I think we can do this. I think that actually is okay. And okay. All right, maybe I fucked that up. Okay, so we got 432, blah, 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 blah. So this, regardless, should work. I mean, kind of. So it looks like we are getting the same result, which means we're not getting a sort. We're not getting sorted here. So whatever's going on here is not cool. Let's see. Maybe I did it wrong. Let's see. What the compare function should be something that takes... Yeah, that's pretty easy. Now, of course, we can get ugly, and we probably will in just a second. And see what this is returning. Well, first of all, let's see if it's being called at all. And the only thing that worries me is compare. I don't think compare is a keyword. But anyway, let's see what the number is before we freaking return it. Let's also learn how to use cut and paste. Always useful. Okay. So compare should be called like a bajillion times. Okay, this is good in a way. It's bad in the sense that it's going to take forever to pronounce, like, it's n log n, so it's going to pronounce, damn it, that's way too much. One more time, we'll wait. Oh, screw it. Alright, we're only going to print the first few then, I think. Maybe we've gone insane here. Okay. Stop it. Stop the web page, I want to get off. Alright, we're going to reload this. That was fun. Stop loading. Reload. Oh good, we might have broken this. Alrighty. Return here. Yeah, we might be effed. Of course, we're never really effed because we can do this. Open a new tab, paste it, close this one down like it never existed. And pin this one. La 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 la. Wait. Is there more than one person? Oh, it thinks there's more than one person in here because my ghost is still there. Alrighty, so what we're going to do here is we are going to print these, but only the first. We'll print the first 100 of these because it seemed like it was actually doing something. Of course, computing it twice isn't really that efficient either, but it looks like it was actually... Okay. Well, that's really, really good. So that shows us the problem here. Is not that we need to console log... It's not the val that we're returning. We're not even getting the right data. I want to do this. So, so letter B, we should be sent the array object, which is an object. I mean, there's nothing bad about that. Yep, that is what we're being sent. Maybe it's S2 that's bad, but I mean, that doesn't make sense. I mean, the next problem, of course, is that it might be, you know, D2 that's not behaving correctly. Well, this looks like it's okay. So now, I want to make sure I haven't really screwed anything up here. S1, Z, I mean, these should all exist. And again, now this is, I realize we're incrementing count twice. So we're only at 50 outputs, but I'm okay with that. D2 gets S1, S2. All right, Pomodoro time, back in 2 and 2. And we are almost back. And we are back. Alright, so one thing that Pomodoro helps with is reminding me that one of the basic questions I had was whether or not this actually means squared in JavaScript. I think it does, but if it doesn't, then the whole problem is we figured that out. Okay, that wasn't good. About this? Is it one of these things where I actually have to say, oh, okay, wait. Again, there is no die command in JavaScript, but if you give it an instruction it doesn't understand, it will die because it hits an undefined instruction. Yep. Is it 7? Okay, no. So this should work. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. So that's not the problem. Let's see if what D2 gets. It looks okay to me. Alright, so now we start talking about stuff like S1x minus S2x. If that one's good, we would expect the other two to be good. But let's see what this does. Interesting. And is that because those are strings? Well, you know what? Maybe it's more fundamental than that. Let's see if S1x and S2x are not defined well. Solid. So S2 is somehow not being defined correctly. So let's see, S1 and S2, let's see what these are. Let's have a little bit here. And of course, one is called from the other, so it's not. Okay. Oh, yes. Fixed star is a number, huh? I probably meant to say I want the star that's that. I'm a moron. I'm a frickin' moron. Okay. So now it looks like we're getting some stuff. Let's go ahead and share my moronicity. Fixed shit. Okay, so once again, you know, we spend some time remembering that I'm a moron. Alright, so now we should actually be in pretty good shape here. We no longer need this. We can just return this directly. We do not need the count variable. We do not need this console log, and I think we don't need this console log either. And now we actually don't even need this val anymore. We're tight. Yeah, let's see what this does. I mean, it's not going to do anything interesting because we're not printing any of our results. But it is fast, which is good. Let's go be gone. And star 17 is now a different array. Okay. So now let's actually see if this changes stars. So if we get the same result here, that means the stars itself is being changed. Ooh, it is. That's a terrible idea, though. I'm going to go ahead and do it like this, because that seems to have the same result. So now what do we want to do? Well, now that we have stars sorted, let's go ahead and print. The closest one, by the way, is going to be Betelgeuse itself. I mean, that we kind of know that. Oh, and here's where it's going to be a problem. Here's where we needed the original ID, because now we've scrambled the IDs. Well, hang on. I wonder. Now, the problem is it looks like star sort by itself tweaks stars, which is never a good idea. Ugh. I mean, we could do something like stars too. Here, but the problem is if this is... for one thing, I don't think you can copy arrays like this either. So there's a whole bunch of problems here. Yeah, there's way too many problems here. And also, print is not a JavaScript thing. Okay. Oh, okay. So those are the closest. Yeah, we still somehow though need to know what the original number was. So in fact, we do need to have ID in there, I think. Can we get away without putting it? I don't think we can, actually. All right. And it's not that big of a pain in the ass to do it, so let's go ahead and do it. It's at this point it's way easier to just do it. Just do it, man. Okay. Now, we could be even more clever and try to make this actually spit out the, you know, stars equals array and get rid of the first line, which is kind of garbage. We're not going to do that, though, because it is the amount of work required. Whoa, didn't like that. The amount of work required is even for me. Is too much. Okay, so we need to add two things. We need to get rid of line one. ID looks like it's fine. We need to also add... we need to declare the stars array. So in fact, we need to replace line one is a better way of saying it. Not really. And we need to overwrite temp... What the hell did I call it? All stars. Somebody once told me... And let's go ahead and bring that up in here. And I think that should be fine. And so we can now go over here, delete this. Yes, yes! I want to delete it. I don't like it anymore. And I want to upload its twin brother. Except they're not, they're fraternal twins. This guy. So now, we do not need, I'm going to go ahead and still say this. I don't, okay. the word yik in front of it, which means it's okay. Okay. So now, unfortunately, I don't remember which order I'm sorting in. I'm pretty sure that this is the correct order. Well, actually, I am 100% sure because the star by itself has the 27. That's obviously the closest to itself. So 27579. Would kind of be nice to have the distance in there too, wouldn't it? Oh, the things I do to answer questions like this. See, the only thing we actually need from this is its ID. We don't really need the whole thing. And then we could say 3.26, Jesus Christ, times math square root of D2 of fixed star from star's eye that we are printing here. Shiny. And this will actually give us enough to answer the question in part. Nice. Okay. Now the only problem for us here is this is not a very useful, this is not even a catalog number from anything. This is a catalog number from an invented database. So what we're going to do now is we're going to see, we could do this by hand because there's not that many of them. But I think I want to do something a little bit more clever than that. Nope. And the other thing is we need to search for the beginning of line. Beginning of line, and this. Okay, here we go. And this is the star. No one gives a rat's ass. Yep. All right. And it'd be nice to have the magnitude in there as well. Okay. So what we need to do now is we need to find a way to name these stars. They already have names. We need to find a way to extract the name from the HYG database and get names, and I could have sworn I've done that too. It basically requires looking through a bunch of fields and picking out the one that's the best identifier. So usually the proper name would be the best identifier. If we don't have that, we can go to HIP HD HR, I don't even know what GL and BF, boyfriend. Catalogs. The HIP HD and HR catalogs are actually, are probably okay. The proper name is the best thing we can give it. And it might be nice to have the magnitude there too, just sort of how bright the star, whether you could see it or not from the night sky. And we will, of course, disclaim our answer by claiming it is a preliminary answer. But all of our answers are preliminary, and we don't need this anymore. Alright, so let's see if there's anywhere here where we have a way to name these. And if we do, it's going to be it's going to some point reference $0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we should be looking for $F6, which is not in here. So the question is, well, let's see if it's anywhere inside of this directory. Suspiciously long time, actually. Okay. This, probably we can't one-line this. Oh, wow, that actually is a spectral type. It looked like it's the word move. Okay, let's see if we can find the word name in here. Star name, no. TZ to name. Ooh, that looks like it's promising. DC asked to name. Okay. That's kind of cool. But not what we need. Alright, I could have sworn I've done this, but this is, I'm less sure that I've done this than I've done other stuff. Hang on, HYG. I think, again, this is the one that does not do it correctly. Oh, hang on. When I say hang on, I mean hang on. This, I think, converts to ecliptic coordinates. I don't think this gives a name. Yeah, it very trivially looks to see if the thing has a name. So let's see how we would sort of want to order this, since we're probably gonna write a program for this. It'd be useful to actually see what we have the documentation in HTML form. So let's look at it in Firefox, and it looks ugly. I'm Barry Carter, by the way. Let's see. The premier is Hipparchus, Henry Draper, Harvard. These are all fairly ugly looking ones. Gliese catalog, the Blair. Okay, this one might actually be important. Is present, then a three-letter abbreviation of the Greek letter, the Bayer subscript number if present, and finally this is the one we need to look at a little bit more. These are not going to give us, these are names. Let's see, I don't think the rest of these are actually, okay, so these might actually be fairly useful then. Unfortunately, he doesn't number these correctly because these are actually multiple fields. So the Bayer Flamsteed. Do I care about the Flamsteed number? Maybe. All right. All right. Let's see if you're in there, Mr. Bayer. That was actually kind of quick. Apparently I'm supposed to use this instead, according to my own notes. Okay. I think we might have to just look at some of these to see, see when, God, there should be a field that just says, there won't be, but there could be a field that just says best name, you know, based on proper name first, but I think we're going to have to F with it. Okay, let me really quickly look for the word proper. H4j parse TGS is going to be way too, I think this is the one I really want to look at, and this is the one that says do not use it. This might have something we could use in it. Motherfucker. Yeah, that's not helpful. All right, let's go ahead and do this. Let's go ahead and do bchyg2name.pl. Always good to include your library, not because it's useful in any way, but because this gives you like three or four lines of code already, and it makes it much easier to start. Find best names for stars in HYGDB. And I think I like the start of the other one's actually pretty good, so let's go ahead and use the HYG, or you know, if we can, HYG to data. The opening of this is pretty good. In fact, what this does is, I'm not going to ignore the sun, but aside from that, I'm going to modify this, obviously. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. Alright, so we will not ignore the sun. It's an important part of our solar system. Well, it's the most important part. Okay, so this says create a hash. I'm not going to re-tab this. Okay, so I'm missing something here. Oh, right, the head is the first line, which is the header line, which we use to declare the hash. My vowels equals this, and then we assign this hash. Need hip ra dec mag. Okay. Let's see what this does in and of itself. This should give us the ra and the dec, but nothing else, which is okay. Pomodoro time, back in 2 and 2. That's right, I said. Okay, we're almost back. And we're back. Alright, yeah, we want to see what this does. I probably need to. Need to rehash it, but that's going to be not enough. I need to also. Oh, wow. That's kind of cool. Yeah, I need to chmod it. This is one of the uglier parts of doing this. Okay, so okay, good, we got that. We don't care about that, we got it though. Alright, so this declares the hash. Now I think what we can do here. We want to keep sort of an array of the stars, which, of course, holding the array in memory is really stupid. We're going to do it, but it's stupid. Excuse me. And we'll call them my stars. My stars, my stars. And we will identify them by their ID, which seems like a reasonable thing to do. And since the ID is going to be really important, we're going to go ahead and give it a special, we're going to give it a special place in our hearts here. Okay. So let's see. Now I had the time of my life. I don't know. Okay. So we're definitely gonna need the X, Y, Z, and the ID fields themselves. So we're gonna say stars ID. ID. That looks really bad. Let's, in fact, not do that. let's copy some fields directly from, we will need some fields. Copy fields directly from HYG. And these fields will be ID, X, Y, and Z, and others as we need them. So we'll say the hash of ID J is equal to the, stars, we're building a new array, equals hash of J. So we just copy this over. And now this is where we try to find the name. So if we have a proper name, we will say, this is a little bit ugly, name equals hash proper, and then next, because we don't, we kind of want to skip all of this stuff, all of the rest of this, excuse me, we don't need to do any more checks after this, but I think we can actually maybe even do better than this, but let's just take a look here. Let's take a look at the bear field is what I'm sort of interested in. So let's do this. Not cool. Alrighty, what are the freaking fields anyway? I mean, I guess we should probably. So there is a bear field. A Flamsteed field, okay, interesting. Okay, so if it's got a proper name, we're never going to see it. Let's do this again, but let's be a little bit more patient. Okay, so we have tau, the very few of them seem to have bear designations. Cat 2, theta. Alrighty, let's see. Okay, I don't really understand why they're necessarily... Why he's necessarily giving the bear as a distinct value. And over here, I guess in six he combines it, BF for bear Flamsteed. But alright. So I think we can do this. So if it has a bear designation, it's going to be, the bear is only going to give us the Greek letter part of it, so we do have to do the constellation as well, which I think he's calling con. Yes, he is. Awesome. Okay. And then if there's no bear designation, we look for the Flamsteed designation. And we should have that. So this is going to now give us all the stars that have none of these. And unfortunately, there's probably going to be a lot of them. That's what I'm not happy about. And for those, we could use, of course, the HIP I think each of these is going to have a HIP catalog number at the very least. Because that's the second field, right? I don't think any of them, well, I guess the sun isn't, but the sun is, we could probably handle the sun as a special case. Let's see. Do I really want to go to HIP this quickly, though? Well, you know, I will, and then we'll look to see if, we'll just test to see if some of the HIPs have other names that I'm somehow missing. Because the fact that we have PHE here is, I'd like to think that this, we could give it a name in the constellation Phoenix, but maybe not. So if none of that works out, we will say HIP catalog. It's HIP to be square. No, it's probably not. Okay, first of all, I want to see how long that takes. I mean, it in some sense, it should take forever. And in some sense, it shouldn't, because Perl is pretty fast. So this is taking... Yeah, that took about 2.7. That's not too bad. Okay. So now, let's take a look at this. We're going to sort the keys of stars in numerical order, which is not necessary. I just do it because I'm an idiot. There's more than one way to do this, as pretty much everything. Let's see, stars, $i, name. Of course, we could also get the XYZ values and the ID values and all this other shit, but this is... And I guess at some point we're going to do this as a... let's be JavaScript-y here. I think JavaScript actually prefers single quotes, but that might not expand the way I want. Okay, so... See what this does. But we can still time it, by the way, while it's printing. Okay, so good, we got that one in. Virtually all of these are gonna have, gamma 3 octans. That's not cool. Well, it might be cool, I don't know. All right, let's look at HIP 1937. Unfortunately, I get the feeling that these are the best names we have for these stars. Elite Dangerous Star Map. Yeah. Wow. This is nice. We have cross references to Gaia. HD, but apparently it doesn't have an actual name. I guess the other thing we could do here is if we kept track of the magnitude, presumably the brighter stars will have names that are not will have names that are not HIP IDs. So we can do this. See what happens. So 2 seconds is starting to annoy me. Okay, that's not what I wanted necessarily, but okay. So I guess what we're going to do now is we're going to grep for the word HIP, which is not hard to do. And yes, I should probably output this to somewhere because I realize I'm wasting time every time I do this. I don't care. So I guess we'll say, show us the lowest magnitudes of things that are HIP stars. And we'll be unhappy if we find some that have names. That is not what I expected. That's weird. So are there stars that have not even a HIP ID? Because that's... Let's just look at that again. That was kind of weird. So it appears there are stars that don't have a HIP ID. For some reason, we're not getting the sorting. Oh, I'm sorting on the fourth field, and these don't have a fourth field. Okay. For the ones with... Okay, see, these are really too bright to be having HIP IDs. However, the fact that there is no HIP ID kind of bugs me. So apparently, even this doesn't always work. Now, of course, the HYG catalog itself, by its name, is built up from three different catalogs, so it's got to be in some catalog. Okay, I'm going to be clever again. So we'll start out with the HIP number. If that doesn't work, we'll go to the HD number. And we will say, if hash of J exists, star ID name will be, watch this, $J, whichever one it is, $#J. So we try hip first, that doesn't work. We use the HD number. But because we are frickin' morons, we will go ahead and uppercase it, so it looks kind of nice. So this is this verges on being stupid. And in this case, I just want to see what the hell's going on here. I want to see if we got it's UC. I always forget it's UC in Perl. All right, let's take a look here. Big mistake here. If we find the hip number, then we go next. If we don't, then we have to go to the HD as the next course of action. So most of these are, that's not what I'm doing what I want. And I think it's because the next is not what I need here. It's actually closer to last. I mean, continue. I don't think Perl has a continue, or if it does, it doesn't mean what it's supposed to mean. I don't think this is going to work either, though. I am, of course, wrong. That is going to work. So hip to be square. Okay, so very rarely. Oh shit. So what the hell are these stars that don't even have a hip number? An HD number? I'm getting unhappy. I guess they might have an HR number. Sounds funny, because HR is also human resources. Alright. Hip hip, let's see. Hooray! Okay, so apparently there's no stars that have a HR number that don't already have an HIP or HD number. Bummer, man. All right, let's just do this then. We can put a parentheses around. This is just so we can get double parentheses if there is no name, because that's what we're looking for right now. Well, let's take a quick look, see what we're getting here. Lots of hips. Good. I actually didn't know that. Okay, so it's this is what we're looking for. So we're getting started at like star. Okay. Think there wouldn't be that many, but apparently there are. Okay. So how NN3001. Okay. Okay, no hip, no HD. HD, HR, so the Gliese catalog number. And we can't do that the same way as the others. Because it has a full name there. Alright. Let's take a quick look at this for, okay. So if we get over here, we have no name for the star. So this will only debug when we have no name for, and I know I misspelled, Gliese's. really crazy about this for loop here. And in fact, yeah, this is getting too complicated. We're going to go ahead and do this as just two separate tests. So if it has a hip number, just call it hip that. If it has an HD number, it's just going to be HD, hash HD. A little bit more complicated, but we don't run into this mess of trying to find where there is no kind of either number. And I probably should have pushed that to git before, huh? Anyway, if it doesn't break, I'll push it to git now. Nice! So it does look like the ones that don't have any other number do have a Gleason number in there. Okay, Pomodoro time. I will be back in 2 and 2. And we're almost back. I have no idea what the hell I'm doing. Yeah, we're back. Okay. So it does look like we have a Gleese identification. Now the question is, do we want to leave it like this, or do we want to say... because it's not clear this is from the Gleese catalog, so let's go ahead and do this. And the only reason I'm doing still leaving an if condition is because there might still be one that isn't. So this will be hash GL, and then we will put in parentheses to show how clever we are. We probably do need to spell this correctly if we're going to do this, though. Hang on. So let's go ahead and GLI. I keep forgetting the bottom of this is actually off of... Alright, I'm going to assume this guy spelled it right. And we will say Gleece. Gleece Navidad. And now, we will debug with what the fuck. Because that is the correct way to debug stuff. Alright, so now let's see what's going on here. Awesome, there is no what the fuck here whatsoever. Okay. So now, we also grabbed the magnitude, right? We didn't grab the RA and declination, which I'm okay with. And we could be, like, super clever and... Oh, God damn it. The moment I say it, it's like, well, now we have to do it. Okay, this looks really ugly, though. What else do we have? I guess it's not going to be a little bit bad because... man, it's still going to be pretty ugly though, isn't it? I mean, there's nothing fundamentally ugly about this, it just takes forever to type. So let's just see if I can live with this. Fooiness. I mean, I could loop through the elements and print them like this. That's the sort of issue. Why I'm hesitating here. But I think maybe this is going a little bit too far. Okay. Let's see what this does. And it wouldn't hurt if we debugged it. We wouldn't get a lot more out of it. And let's see if this does what we want. I mean, the magnitudes are getting away from us, but... Ooh! Actually, we probably don't want the... We probably want the absolute magnitude. No, we do want the magnitudes, because we're going to end up saying how bright it is as viewed from Earth. There's not that many bright stars near, name, ID... Yeah, we're not going to throw all of them, obviously. There's over 100,000 of them. But this is looking... good-ish... All right, so the only thing we really need to add to this, but it's pretty much a complete, well, okay, we're going to make it a little bit more compact, even though this is, in fact, this is so ugly, I'm going to actually create a new line for it. We want to make this compact just because we have to save, I don't really even know why we have to save bytes, but apparently, but we're trying to make this file as small as possible, I guess. Although there's a lot more we could do to make it small, so I don't really, but this is what we did with the last file, so it's good enough for this one. Now let's see, the issue here is going to be, of course, this, even like this, it's going to be bigger than, and I think I don't want... With the maybe the exception of Gleece, I don't think I want spaces there between hip and the catalog number. So hip this, HD that, and then with GL we'll just leave it the way it is. Same for Flamsteed and this, yeah. Really, really knock down in terms of the number of spaces. It's just right there. There we go. That's tight. Literally tight, in the sense of it's a pretty tight... Let's see if Beetlejuice is in there. I mean, it better be, but yeah, there we are. Magnitude, I didn't know the magnitude of 0.0. Cool. All right, so now... Somebody still told me. All right, so now we're going to... I need to push this to get really badly, don't I? I'm really bad about that. I mean, technically I could look at my own videos and figure out what I did, but, I cringe. I think no one should be looking at my videos. So if you are, you know, feel bad about yourself. Okay, let's go ahead and re-upload the allstars.js with the new information that we have. And let's just run this program again, which should give us very similar results, maybe. Yep, so I fucked something up, obviously. I missed a quotation mark somewhere. Something. I actually probably could, like when we're testing, upload a much smaller version of AllStars, or it's possible this is the file itself is just too big. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this might have killed it. Okay. Oh, I forgot to add the freaking. God damn it. I suck. Nice. Kind of. We will now, we will now. So the distance is important. We do want that. But I think here we can just console log stars I. The whole thing. Okay, so the 10 closest stars to Betelgeuse are. Well, Betelgeuse itself, obviously. And obviously, we probably need to do a better job of this precision we don't have. And I guess it's 3.262, the guy says, so let's go ahead and be more accurate there. We don't really need the X, Y, and Z coordinates. We just basically want the name. That's actually all we need, huh? The name and the distance. I mean, there's probably more stuff I'm not thinking of at the moment, but this is kind of what we want. Yeah, not super fast. Could have sworn it was faster before. Okay, this came back pretty damn fast last time. I'm pretty sure I didn't create an infinite loop just by putting in dot name here. If I did, terrible person. Let's do this again. You were fast the first time. Okay, now I am suspicious. Let's see. Well, my live stream shows that it's doing pretty well. So I haven't lost the internet. There's no way that just changing this by the word name. Well, let's undo that change and rerun. If this comes out fast, I'll be freaking amazed. Okay, good. So the problem is not just trying to get the name out of it. There's something more seriously wrong here. All right. I'm going to do a reload. And I'm going to leave page, which means I might lose the dot name that I just did, but hopefully everything else will stick around. All right, rock and roll. There we go. Oh, I did lose the last change. It's beginning to bug me that this might be the thing that's breaking it. Wow, that didn't do what I wanted it to. I'm right here. I'm also right here. I'm the other Barry Carter. I'm awesome. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. And I guess we also want the magnitude of the store. That would be useful. At some point, we're going to print this out in a way that's actually useful. In other words, we're going to print it out in a way that I think we're going to use tech here to print it out, or we might have to do something a little bit more clever. But okay. It seems to think I'm here multiple times, which I'm not obviously, but it's getting confused. Crap, where does it think I am? Shit, is it putting crap at the bottom? No, okay. I am right here. All right. Okay, so the closest stars to Betelgeuse are actually quite far away. Sorry, they're quite faint. The closest visible star is HIP 27386. That's Betelgeuse's own magnitude. I think we can go a little bit further than this. I'm going to try to go until we have the star that's like somewhat recognizable. Which clearly we're not going to get. Let's save this to get just because I forgot. So we did change some other shit. Alrighty. Okay, and we need to obviously truncate this. Let's go up to 50, and from there we can sort of count down how many we need. Okay, so this is the one that is actually... Did someone just come into chat now? So, New Orionis, New being the Greek letter, appears to be the first star that has sort of a non-hippie name. It's funny because I said hippie. Okay. Alrighty, so now... The problem was on astronomy, we could not create a table. Let's poke this up, but I think we can do that in tech, and obviously since we're printing what is known as sort of automatedly, if that's what you want to call it. The other problem, of course, is going to be we want to be able to accept any star as input, and then provide... Damn, there's not a lot of frickin' bright stars that are physically close to Betelgeuse. Might be the only one, actually. And the really cool thing is if we make the table sortable, which might be asking too much. Right now it's sorted by distance, obviously. Now there's a temptation to go even further and see if we can just put in all stars that are less than 100 light years from Betelgeuse. Which is what we'll do now. And so we should be stopping about 130... I meant to say 133. Alright. So now let's sort of glide towards getting a stack exchange answer. So we will console log. We're not going to... Right now this hasn't, like, prints no HTML. I think we can mention this as our REPL, but I don't think we can... This is not generic enough right now that it could be an HTML application. So I'm getting lazy here, actually. All right, so, so we did discover how to make a table in LaTeX. We did not, I'm pretty sure you can't, I've done this before. We looked at the markup earlier, and we decided that the markup is pretty sucky, actually. Very limited. Images, styling lists, I don't think you could do... Yeah, you can't do a table. Pre-formatted might actually work for us. Ooh, HTML. Note that we support a very limited set of HTML because we suck like balls. I'm pretty sure it doesn't support table. And I think last time we actually found out what the table. Well, actually, it's not that difficult. I mean, you can just go over here to tech paste, and it'll, it's not a big mystery how tech handles tables. Assuming the site comes up, of course. That's the. Oh, come on! This is one of my favorite sites. I'm pretty sure you can't do sortable tables in tech because that's not a concept that tech has. All right, Pomodoro back in 2 and 2. And we're almost back. And we are back. Okay. I'm pretty sure this is not going to go well. Unfortunately, I don't think tech has the concept of dynamic tables. So what we're going to do here, actually, which is, we're going to, there's something more generic we need here. We should have a way of converting CSV, for example, to tech without having to do it by hand each time. That's something that would be generically useful. And let me see if there's actually a, see now I was going to do it for myself, but see if there's a CSV to tech. Well, looks like someone's already done it for us. Except it's in Python. So it doesn't count. Now, before I realize you're going to say, hey, wait a minute, we're printing out in JavaScript, aren't we? And we are. We can also print out in CSV as an option. Actually, technically, it should be CSV to LaTeX. Not LaTeX, LaTeX. RubyScript, AppleScript, that's nice. Now, what language should we write this CSV to LaTeX thing in? Guess, you're going to guess. That's right, JavaScript, because it's going to make it a lot easier for everybody. I want to write it in Perl, though, like I wrote this thing in Perl. but it would be a lot more useful in JavaScript. Must include... Okay. Actually. And not everyone names their X to Y things with a 2 in them, by the way. That's kind of a... Yeah, maybe that is what I meant. Okay. So this is fun. That's a LaTeX table editor, which we've actually used it obviously before. Let's see what this is not quite what I'm looking for though. And I think this was ugly enough that I didn't want to use it. So did I ever get tech? I didn't think I ever got tech paste to work. But I mean, there's like a billion sites like it, so. And there's tons of these suckers. Oh, you've got to be fucking kidding me. I'm not going to register, you sons of bitches. I am, however, going to remember that I don't open things in new pages automatically. I'll just do that a few times. This is actually nice, but not what I wanted, actually. Did I see the word pricing in there? Hope not. Oh, I did see the word pricing in there. I don't think formally there is such a thing as tables, but... Boy, that I was this close to maybe getting something I didn't want to see, but I think we lucked out here. Okay. Give me. Oh, there we go. So now the question is, could I post this into astronomy.stackExchange? And the answer is, let's find out. Well, I think we can actually do this, though. Okay, we cannot do that. Let's see if we can do this. Oh, we don't need this anymore, obviously. Yeah. And I know we've done this before, because I think when we wanted to give our answers to one of the other problems that I'm never going to answer... we actually started building up a little bit of a table there. Gosh, I wish I remember what it was. It was the it was the Jovian moons, actually. Occultations? Oh, what the hell was it? Closest, stream, notes, Nagios. Yeah, there we are. This is a beautifully long thing for something that's never ever going to happen. So this presumably will be printable in astronomy. That's really nice. I like that. Okay. So let's do that. That's kind of nice. Let's see, where do we go? We're going to create something. This is actually not, doesn't need to be an astro. LaTeX to CSV to latex.pl. And no, this is misusing Perl's comment feature. I don't care, though. converts a CSV file to a LaTeX table. Additional, very basic. You probably need to edit table after creation. Wait, I said I was going to do it in frickin' JavaScript, didn't I? Shit. And I really should, because that's going to help a lot more people than this. Alright, fuck it. Alright, I forgot what I was going to do. Our new REPL. You never ever run out of REPLs. This is going to be Twitch CSV, not CVS, to allow, I'm not even properly case it. Okay. Why is there no, this is the wrong type? I did not want that. I wanted HTML, CSS. Something's funky. Yes, I do. All right, let me go back to my REPLs. I probably need to clean some up anyway. For some reason, that just became HTML. No. Where the fuck is this? Oh, fuck you. Where's my script.js file? This is not cool. Something has gone very wrong. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and delete your mama. I want to delete you. No, I don't want to go to you. I want to delete you. How do I delete one? They're very generous with space, but... Oh, you know what? I think you might have to actually be in the REPL to delete it. No? Well, that was particularly bad there. All right, awesome. We have really effed this up. Oh, there we go. REPL go bye bye. There we are. All right. Now, we're going to try that again. Not good that it's failed to connect. And then, I mean, we could obviously put it in the script.js crap ourselves. But if it's not giving it to us, there's something maybe more fundamentally wrong here with REPL. And we're not going to report it to anyone or anything, but that is the kind of thing that would be useful for them to know. So this is not looking good at all. Not good. All right, let's go ahead and do a shift reload here. Leave. I want to leave the page. I want to leave everything behind. Oh, well, now it looks like we're at least going to get... They don't exist, but at least we're going to get the correct files. No, we're not. Buggy. Let's do it one more time. Do it. And then if that doesn't work, we'll F with it.
Okay.
Oh! Well, this could be... Well, actually, it's not stopping me from doing anything. That's interesting. I'm presumably out of space, but... maybe that's why these files aren't showing up, but that's still not really... Then it should just stop me completely. Okay, if this doesn't work, we will do some copying. Okay. And now, maybe that's why I can't create anything more than an index file. Oh, Jesus. And I think the problem is the one huge file I have is going to be big enough to cause problems. Well, no, it's 10.8 megs. So it's not actually enough to cause... Bus. God, I hate my life. Yeah, now we're good. Oh, fuck you. There are no buses. Is that a bus? Motherfucker. This is the kind of thing you want to, you know, beat the crap out of them for. This is the kind of thing you want to hunt them down. I'm not advising anyone to not do that. In other words, if you do want to hunt them down and kill them, be my guest. I obviously can't make it legal, though. Okay. Oh, good, I'm stuck in CAPTCHA heaven. Hell. We might have to take drastic measures. We might have to figure out what the hell drastic measures are and then take them. Chim chiminy, chim chim chiminy, chim chim chiri. This is getting annoying to me. Chim chiminy, chim chiminy, chim chim chiroo. This is, I'm gonna have to fuck you. Alright, if this is gonna be one more, we're gonna have to do something about this. Yep, we're fucked. Alright. First of all, I need to figure out which my biggest... God damn it, see, this is the problem now. I need to see how big these are if I'm going to start deleting them. I'll be darned. They do tell me. Can I sort by... Okay. This one... Okay, now I'm going to be real clever. I'm going to download... Just fuck you, we don't need that. See, if I can download this, I can actually delete it completely, or at least delete the big files in it. Unfortunately, it looks like I am being fucked. I think because I went over and they just sort of noticed it, they're going to fuck me over now. And I don't like being fucked over. Well, that's not true. Depends on who's doing the fucking over. But I clearly don't like being fucked over in this way by the CAPTCHA. Alright, here we go. Come on, man. You gotta give me something here. Well, it's coming down. It's coming down, 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 doobie, doobie, down. And I'm not going to delete the whole thing, but I will delete the larger files in here, which I believe. And there are some. Okay, this is pretty chunky. I'll give that to you. Motherfucker, what the hell did I put in this thing? I could do an unzip minus L on the partial, but I'm gonna actually. Oh, fuck. I don't even know why I bothered to save the. Oh, okay, so it will have to come down, the whole file will have to come down before I can figure out what the hell is the huge shit in here that I'm killing everyone for. Because I want to actually do, like, rep. I do like rep, and I don't want to be wasting their space unnecessarily. Okay, let's see. That's going to take a while. Alright. 2, 1. It's Pomodoro time. We'll be back in 2 and 2. And hopefully the zip file will finish downloading by then. And we are almost back. And we're back. Okay, good. So now, let's see what's taking up all the crappy space here. Okay, land use.bin and this TIFF file look like they're the, No, don't look at it, don't look at it. Delete. And, oh no, fuck. I did that. I just made the same mistake twice. Okay, now I want to go back to the list of my REPLs. So hopefully that now takes up a lot less space. Orb.js, ooh, Twitch data server presumably now takes up less space. It'll just need to figure it out in a little while. So we're looking for something. Oh, fuck, son of a bitch. Alright, React testing. Stop doing this. I get the feeling they literally put this in while I was programming. So that's why it's like fucking me up so much. It's like suddenly you're over limit, even though you weren't before. Okay, so let's go ahead and download this. And I realize this is tedious and not very useful to you, and you're welcome. Alright, let's see how this... Oh, wow. Wait. That came down very, very quickly. And yet, it's supposedly using up a ton of space. So, something is funky here. I mean, I realize it's not going to be completely up to date, but still, that's 58 point. Okay, that one's the one we just fixed, presumably. React testing, 125.7 megabytes. How the hell did you come up with that? Attempt to just. To delete it, because we have the files now. And if it thinks it's that big, something something very strange going on here. Alright, I'm not even that much of a fan of React. So this should buy me back a ton of space. Or it shouldn't. I mean, you know, one or the other. C-spice attempt, which I know failed, so we can definitely get rid of this completely. But I'll download it anyway, just because I am that fucking retarded. I think this is basically just to delay people. Seriously? What's wrong with you people? I think I might be in an infinite loop again. Either that or I don't know what the hell a crosswalk, a zebra crossing. Alright. That's enough. Let's just see if we can force the download. Oh yeah, there we go. Apparently we don't. But I get the feeling the only thing useful here is going to be I get the feeling this is not going to be what we. There's nothing in this that's worth keeping. The large file in here is literally, I can delete that and keep the rest of it. But since it doesn't really work, I don't really care that much. How much space am I using up here? Yeah, it's not too bad. Okay. Download. Myself, don't want to download myself. Whoa, that is a really terrible rendition of All By Myself. So 19 megabytes. This is just, we can just keep doing this. 21 megabytes. Will it beat data server? And I forgot actually how big it was, so I don't know. The one problem here is we're not actually seeing the file, so I don't know if I'll be able to do individual deleting, but I probably don't care. Ooh. How big was this piece of shit? Big, I guess. Now, there is something I could do here if I were, you know, impatient. I could do a wait file, too, which basically says, tell me when this file here, or whatever file I want, has a non-zero size. It does a poll, and it lets me know. The problem here is going to be that I don't really have anything to do in the meantime. So I should obviously. So there's really no point in putting a timer on it, putting a wait on it. There we go. Let me see. Just out of curiosity, let's see what is the yes. Oh, geez, the whole C-spice frickin' library. Yeah, that's not good. All right, C-Spice is going to go bye-bye now. Yeah, this was a major failure. Okay. And let's see. HYG star map. This is probably the one that is actually, that has the full star list. So I'm now going to do a reload of this page, and hopefully it will figure out that I'm not using up a ton of space. Yeah. Did not figure that out. In fact, it didn't see any of my deletions, I don't think. Twitch data server, did I decide that we needed that? I mean, I'm never going to use it, and I got rid of the big files in it, but I apparently doesn't recognize that. Maybe if I were to upgrade my account? No. Maybe if we were to log out and log back in, it would help. That is, account-wide unlimited storage. That is something you could really, really, really abuse. It's not a bad price either. I'm not going to do it, but anyway. So now what do I want to do? I guess I want to go home. This This is, you know, I really don't want to log. Oh shit. What is my profile? I'm kind of curious. I am freaking awesome. Okay. I actually have more than I know that I have more than these REPLs here, but yeah. Okay, I'm gonna have to log out and log back in. Hopefully, I'll remember my. Hopefully, it's memorized my password. And just in case you're wondering, I do have a second account that I could use, but I won't. Oh, good. Now it doesn't see the captcha, so it's really, really confused. There's a hidden captcha. Oh shit! Do I have ad blocker turned on? Maybe I can turn that off. I don't think I do, actually. Okay. Yeah. So we are fucked. I know I have a second account here that I really don't want to use though right now, so let's see. Motherfucker. All fields are fucking filled in, you piece of shit. I guess I could log in through GitHub. Which, this is a different account, it turns out. Yep. Ooh. Interesting. All right, so what are my REPLs here? 1 out of 100 megabytes. REPLet sucks. Yeah. All right. So I guess we don't really need, this is actually Barry Carter, what am I here? Barry Carter 1 from GitHub. So this is terrible, but I'm gonna do it anyway. It really can't stop me. Now we're gonna call this Twitch CSV to La Tech. Finally, create me my REPL. Then take forever to bring something up, please. Oh my god. Yeah, someone needs to kill these people. These recapture people have gone too far. Oh wow, okay. That's strange that they don't have a script.js. That's pretty unusual, actually. Let's go ahead and waste some git space. Let's look at some examples. Oh, good! There are no examples for each. I get the feeling they're working on the site right now, which is why we're seeing so much bullshit. So, let's see how we can get away with this. Well, we actually might be able to do this. Okay. All right. And if this works, that means we have the minimal stuff necessary to, there we go. Nice. I get how, yes, I got it. Yes. You sons of bitches. All right. So now we're going to actually try doing some CSV to LaTeX, if I remember what the hell I'm doing. Okay. So I guess what we need first is some CSV. Or actually, that was my phone, obviously, but let me check to see how long I've been online, which means I'm probably going to... Okay, I've been online for about 2 hours and 24 minutes. Long time. I'm happy with that. So... And it's also theoretically possible that REPL will fix its shit by the time I get back. By the time I have lunch to get back. Alright, thank you for watching the stream, and goodbye for now. I might be back later today, I might be back tomorrow. I might die. We don't know.